auction. Well, joining us for this panel to discuss it is Thomas Waits. He's an Austrian MEP with the Greens. All right, I'll start with you, Thomas. This issue, why is it important and why is it coming up now?
Well, there's more and more young people realizing what kind of agricultural system there is in place. They see the cruelty of animal transports, they see the cruelty in slaughterhouses, they see the mass breeding production, and they just don't want to eat that stuff anymore. They just don't want to support that system with their money anymore. So they turn vegetarian, they turn vegan, and I think that's very understandable.
But it's not. It's been going on for decades. I think the request has come in about 10 years ago, but it's only now. So why the delay, let's say? Why is the EU only now starting to listen?
I absolutely have no idea why they're listening at all. I mean, I don't think that this is in any way should be a candidate for EU regulation. I'm sorry, but vegans can't read ingredients.
But it's important to know what's in your food if you
look,
know.
This is a job for the market, right? There are a lot of people who are becoming vegetarian and vegan. They want to buy vegetarian and vegan food. Clever companies will write, "We are vegan," like on your video footage there. And then those people will go and buy. The idea that this has to be regulated is just bonkers.
I think citizens have a right to know what they buy. They have a right to obviously see what they buy. If you buy some sweets for your kids and then realize that they are made with pork gelatin or they
like
are kind of covered with pork
fat. Read the ingredients.
Yeah?
I mean, people don't need to have their hands held all the time. And that's the problem. It's this hand-holding.
The vegetarian lobby who've been pushing for this actually since 2008. They've been writing to the Commission asking them to define vegan and vegetarianism, and they were hoping that Brexit and the European elections wouldn't overtake this matter. And we've seen that it would, because this morning Margrethe Schginas, the spokesperson over in the European Commission, said, "Look, we will not be dealing with this issue. We will pass it on to post-2019 when the new commission is put in place." So it's an issue actually that they do want to see addressed.
The consumers already have the power, and the power is in their wallet. You know, you reward the companies which do what they see as the right thing, and the problem's solved. If you don't like meat, don't throw blood on a butcher. Just don't buy meat.
But then that's the question. What is so wrong about regulating the labelling of products like these?
Exactly.
Well, what is so wrong about it? Because, well, for one thing, there would be the need to add an extra burden on people. I mean, the second thing is it adds to this cloying.
But where's the extra burden for people? Burden maybe for business that people obviously see whether something is vegetarian or not.
Do people need to have
vegan
stamped on it?
I want to in wine gums and you can't eat that if you're vegan.
Right, beyond, it's not a
beyond,
role for Brussels.
Beyond labelling, though, I want to bring this up.
It's not an EU role.
Because veganism, vegetarianism, and traditionally it's been linked to policies of the left or on Greens or no. Now it's becoming more mainstream. Is it being politicized? Is there a stigma attached to veganism and vegetarianism,
well,
which is why people get so emotional about it?
There is a stigma because it's clear that the more vegan you are, the less of a sense of humor you have because you subscribe to a fundamentally
Thomas,
joyless existence.
You've got to reply to that.
Yeah, that's a completely ridiculous announcement. I mean, I'm not a vegan person at all. Yeah, I think I have a big sense of humor, but I know many of my friends that also have a big sense of humor that has nothing to do with that at all. Every single person and citizen has the right to feed themselves the way they want to, and to buy the products they prefer,
and they should
be supported with a very clear labeling. What has the industry to hide?
Look, and it's not a health issue. At the end of the day, if you have an allergy, for example, to something that's in your wine gum, you can get a reaction on your face. I've seen it happen. Friends of mine have had convulsions because they've been allergic
Basically,
to something in their food and they haven't known because
of the
label.
It comes down to whether you want to take responsibility for your own choices or whether you want a government or an institution to take responsibility for you.
Yeah, but you can't put all the responsibility on citizens, yeah? We're not selling cars without brakes and then asking
Seriously,
the citizens
you
to decide
what you're
whether they take a car with brakes or without
brakes. Precisely my point.
Yeah?
Look at that.
I mean...
Look at that emotional discussion coming up.
As meat.
All right. Well, let's move on now to Germany. Well, not a lot more to talk about because according to a recent New York Times article, this is again a story on stereotypes, a crisis of masculinity in the East could explain the rise of the far right. Let's take a look. When the Berlin Wall fell, thousands of people flooded to the West looking for work. Two-thirds of them were women who never came back. As the West prospered, the East fell behind, and for many, hope turned into disappointment. When the far-right AfD began to rise, one group was at the center of its support, according to the New York Times, the Angry Eastern Man. It says men in Eastern Germany are twice as likely to vote for the party as women. And in Chemnitz, as far-right riots surged in August, men reportedly outnumbered women 10 to 8. Okay, angry men. Can we attribute the rise of the far right to masculinity and the lack of women in that area?
I'd say yes. I mean, look, it's clear to anyone who's lived any sort of normal life that women tend to be more intelligent, more emotionally intelligent, and also just generally nicer people than men. I mean, I've been an angry man in my teenage years. I was a total scumbag. I mean, I didn't go on far right marches and I didn't hit people. But, you know, I certainly was highly unreasonable.
But is that really the demographic of people voting for the far right?
Well, just to back your point, Eurostat data does prove that women do perform very well and as well as men, even better in school, but that's not reflected in the labour market. But as regards angry men voting for the far right, not much to say on that, but it is, at the end of the day, all about inequality and all about having money or not in your pocket, and that's why we see such a big divide in the East and West.
Well, Marine Le Pen's a woman.
I think there's also an aspect of a questioned role model where there's not a real a new version of a role model that has walked the line through society. And I think many of these men don't find themselves in society as they used to do, so they feel questioned in their role model, and that kind of also makes them react in a way also to vote for right-wing policies, just to kind of secure their culture against others.
And I mean, this isn't just a German thing either.
No,
I mean, this is happening across Europe. We see it with the Tommy Robinson stuff in Britain. Mm. I mean, but you know, you see it with people like
and politicians. Politicians capitalize on that, don't they? When you know, towards genders, talking towards specific genders.
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. Look, there's a thing with masculinity where you know what? I consider myself to be a relatively progressive man, relatively. And, you know, but there is still a feeling that, you know, as a man, you must provide. As a man, you must be the breadwinner and be in charge to a degree. But that now, in a sort of the globalization, the buffeting winds of globalization, there's a powerlessness which turns you basically into an angry... I can't say what I was going to say.
I mean, it's much easier to steer aggression within the male community than within the female community, because females...
Because I was going to ask on the
very
flip
often,
side.
Yeah, very often look on the bigger picture, on the community, while men tend to go more for their ego. Yeah?
And it depends, of course, on the issues as well. If you feel the issues, like if you look at women in Poland, a lot of them vote in favour of law and justice, the very conservative right-wing party, because they're doing a lot for them when they're on maternity leave. So it really depends on what's
there's an excellent
at stake in your thing on that.
Sorry.
No, it is a very interesting discussion on demographics and who votes for what and why, of course. All right.